Let's turn now to Anambra State, where the countdown to November's governorship election is on. But confusion remains over who exactly will be contesting it. For the People's Democratic Party, two candidates, Ugochukwu Uba and Valentine Ozibo, have been named by two separate high courts. There was a similar controversy within the All Progressives Grand Alliance. It remains unclear who either party will field for the vote, and there could be further legal action after November's poll.
We're now joined by National Publicity Secretary of the People's Democratic Party, PDP, Kola Olobodiyan. Glad to have you join us on Newsnight, Kola.
Thank you very much.
Let's, the same to you. Let's start it. I'd like to start this with a quote from Justice Rhodes Vivo. This was a case he delivered between Uzodinma in 2011 and one of the, that brought came to the court. He said, the court will never allow a political party to act arbitrarily or as it likes. Political parties must obey their own constitution, and once this is done, there will be orderliness, and this will be good for politics and the country. Mm. Now, I quote this because the argument is that your card-carrying members, they're saying that you set aside your own constitution and guidelines in the conduct of your own primaries.
That's not correct. It's absolutely incorrect. And I say so because if you follow the trajectory, you will understand that we had already had our ad hoc members for the primary election elected. We already had an executive from the ward level to the state. But the Chris Uba group went to court. And the court ruled that party must discountenance.
Is it the Chris Uba or
Ugochukwu Uba? Ugochukwu Uba.
Needed to be clarified.
Went to court. And the court said that party must discountenance the existing ESCO in the favor of his own group. The existing ESCO also went to court. And party also recognized them. In that instance, the party had two court judgments. Mm. And in line with our rules, in line with the constitution of the People's Democratic Party, we dissolve both ESCOs. Mm. Because they had become a problem, so to say. But we also went to court. Sorry, before we dissolved the two ESCOs, we went to court to seek a stay of execution on the judgment concerning the Uba group. And the court ruled that even the three ad hoc delegates that we had elected have become a nullity. It went further to state that even the zonal ESCO that were elected far away in March had become a nullity. In that guise, the game plan appeared to be such that we cannot produce a candidate. But the constitution of the People's Democratic Party, like a structured party that we are, also provided for super delegates. So since the court has said the other classes of delegates cannot participate in the election, what we had left was the super delegates. And the constitution didn't say all delegates. It didn't say all delegates. Because if you, we will talk,
I will come back. Yeah, because when my colleague takes a question, I'll come back to
the super delegates. We talk about the issue of, oh, how did you get quorum?
Yes.
When you go to the National Assembly, in the National Assembly, it's about all the seats. That word, all, which is absent in the Constitution of the People's Democratic Party. So the Constitution says that it shall consist. It didn't say it shall consist of all. Mm-hmm. So in that wise, the safest arena for us to have our Congress was to use the super delegates. And this is not the first time that the party will be relying on super delegates.
So, but it seems
situations like this.
It seems from observers, the point of view of observers, that this court ruling was in favor of the party that actually wanted a particular person and not the other. So now the fundamental question that's been asked, exactly who is PDP's candidate for the Anambra election come November 6.
The candidate of the People's Democratic Party, elected in line with established rules of the party as contained in our constitution as amended in 2017, is Valentine Osibo. And you will recall, like I said, if you have been following this trajectory, Festus Okoye, who is in charge of information in INEC, came out and declared that it was Valentine that was legally elected in line with the rules of the party, and that the INEC also followed the Congress held by the National Working Committee, chaired by Prince Uche Secondus.
Okay.
So, in the face of this, I don't see where they are.
But it seems convenient for the PDP to go to another court, a court of coordinate jurisdiction, giving conflicting judgments, and not a higher court, a court of appeal, for example, if you were so confident of your position.
In which matter did we go to a court of... in which matter did we go to that court? Of coordinate jurisdiction, which matter?
In establishing the fact that Valentine Osibo is the...
The party never went to any court. The People's Democratic Party as a political party, we didn't go to... What do we need to go to court for? Immediately we finish the primary in Anambra, and the report was returned to the party. The party sat down, and in line with our rule, there's provision for appeal.
Okay.
Let me finish this point.
Okay.
Within 24 hours, we were supposed to have had the appeal committee seated. And the appeal committee constitutes of the national chairman and the members of the National Working Committee, as well as statutory members of BOT. So it's a well-respected committee.
Okay.
Jennifer, who wrote a petition, was waited for 24 hours. She didn't come.
Okay.
Contacts were made to her.
Okay.
She said they should give her additional 48 days. The constitution provides for 24 hours.
Okay.
So we went to the following day, for her. When she was not available, petition was reviewed. And for lack of merit, it was dismissed.
All right.
And from there, INEC, that participated in our Congress in Anambra, released the code. And in the time past, to submit a name in INEC used to be manual. But you know, with this electronic system that INEC has adopted, they must give you a code. So INEC gave us a code, gave the party a code, the national chairman of the party a code.
Now
in line with the national secretary.
Call up, we don't have all the time.
The name of Valentine Osibo.
Let's trash.
Submitted.
Yeah, we don't have all the time. Let's trash this issue.
Very good.
I was Article 25(1) of your constitution says 2/3 of statutory delegates and the 3-man ad hoc delegates was supposed to be used for the election, but you jettisoned this, your constitutional provision, and brought in what you call super delegates.
That's not correct, sir. From what you have read to me, is there any way that the word shall appear?
I don't understand what you mean. This is your constitution.
Article 25(1). I'm not contesting the fact that it's the constitution of the Democratic Party. But the question is simply, is there any way we have read there that mandate shall?
So how does that affect?
So the way it affects it is very simple.
How?
The party has a list of those who should participate in the process. Does it now mean that, if this number of people, let's have we had a mishap, and this number of people were no longer available to participate in the election, that will not continue with the Congress?
You will have have to undo your
The constitution is unambiguous. It is your reading of it that makes it look ambiguous. Because even in deciding this issue of Anambra, the party went as far as inviting no less than 3 SANs to arrive at our decision.
But aren't you concerned that the court are not the ballot box
we're going to take a break.
The outcome of political processes.